Let's get into some of these stories on the sports coma. Starting off with Ndamukong Suh. Of course, we had to tweet some time ago about Ndamukong Suh. Of course, he was released a few days ago by the Miami Dolphins in a cost move to try to free up some money. They have a whole culture change that they're trying to do in Miami. And a lot of those players, Maurice Pouncey is another guy that wants out. A bunch of those guys are moving on. I don't know what kind of culture change they're talking about. To me, I don't think that coach is very good out there, but he's changing the whole game. And Ndamukong Suh is one of those guys. Of course, it's reported by ESPN's Diana Rossini that he is having dinner right now with the Saints brass, and hopefully, and we'll know something by tomorrow whether or not to see what kind of money. And of course, he's definitely, as it was reported, looking for a deal between 12 to 17 million a year. I don't know if I know the Saints can't pay that, but Mickey Loomis with these fantastic Luminomics type contracts where he creates phantom years and all this kind of stuff. So with him, the magician, Mickey Loomis operating, I'm pretty sure that they can probably do something to kind of fit that contract into place, but it can't be too rich. Maybe they'll sign or give him a big signing bonus or something like that. If anybody could pull it off, is what I'm saying, is Mickey Loomis. So that's what's being reported. We won't know nothing about this until tomorrow, because he has other visits set up as well. But the Saints, hopefully they don't let him out the building. Adding Ndamukong Suh next to Cam Jordan and Alex Okafor and Sheldon Rankins and David Onyemata and Tyler Davidson. Could you imagine that defense, a front four and the, oh my goodness. And I forgot to mention Kakaha, my bad, and Trey Hendrickson, my bad, and El-Kadeem Muhammad. Wow. Could everybody out there who's a Saints fan who've been craving dominant defense from the Dome era, from the Dome Patrol era, say wow with me? Wow. Absolutely mind-blowing if the Saints can add that guy to the defense. They're having dinner with him right now, so y'all keep y'all fingers crossed on that. Hopefully we can pull that off and also keep it moving. Let's talk about the Thomas Morstead extension. We're going to get into that. I touched on a little bit of it. But the Thomas Morstead extension is a 5-year extension that they did for the punter on Friday, of course, to free up some years, free up some of that cap money, actually. And he was scheduled to earn $4.15 million in salary and bonuses this year, with the highest salary cap figure of any punter in the NFL, which is about $14.85 million. And he earns it. Thomas Morstead, in my estimation, is the best punter in the league. Yes, I said it over Shane Leckler, whoever you're going to call, but this guy is the best punter in the NFL, and he is definitely a Hall of Famer in my book, and I'm pretty sure most of you guys out there agree with me. He turned 32 last week, so he got a little age on him, but he made the Pro Bowl in 2012, and according to Football Focus, they recognize him as a first-team All-Pro punter in 2017. His career averages are 47 yards per punt, 41.4 in net yards per punt. Both of them rank among the best in the NFL history. Could you all say future Hall of Fame Pro Bowl punter with me? Because that's what he is. He's also a sixth man, the former Saint Man of the Year selection, nationally recognized for his community work. Remember, he did that stuff for Minnesota, the campaign out there with Minnesota. He didn't have to do that, but he did it. But that just show you what kind of dude Thomas Morstead is an excellent person and a giving person. And if you give, let that be a lesson to you. The bigger you give, the bigger you receive. You can't give little and expect big. You got to give big to get big. Y'all remember that. That's the universal law. And that's why so many wealthy or really good people give big and generously give, because they know they will receive big, such is the case. 5 years, $20 million, roughly about $9 million is what his contract is. He frees up some money in particulars. And I think it's congratulations on the Saints for doing that. We love Thomas Morstead. We're happy to have him back. And I just think it's a terrific move. Good work, Saints. Okay, let's take a look at our next topic. We're going to go into the fact that the Saints received about $3 million cap credit for the Nick Fairley deal. Now, we're going to go over this. Now, this is reported by NOLA.com that's reporting that the New Orleans Saints are going to receive a $3 million credit related to Fairley, according to a source from ESPN. So it's actually an ESPN article that they're quoting from. Now, of course, we know the particulars behind Nick Fairley, his ongoing grievance. But the Saints are looking for some salary cap relief, you know. It's $3 million cap credit. Now, he signed a four-year deal with the Saints last March, but he never played in 26, signed a contract with the Saints, but he never played in 2017 when they did it. Now, he had that heart condition, and of course, he couldn't pass the physical, so the Saints put him on the non-football illness list and then ultimately released him in February. So his contract included about $8 million in signing bonus, which should have been spread across the 4 years of the deal for salary cap purposes. But the Saints paid $4 million of the signing bonus before they discovered the heart condition. In cutting Fairley, the Saints escalated the remaining proration of the signing bonus, which would have been $2 million each year for 2018 to 2020, up to 2018. He was supposed to count for $6 million in dead cap space for 2018, but because the Saints only pay half the bonus, they received $3 million credit for that portion, which is better than nothing. But when we come back on the other side of the break, we're going to finish up this story. We're also going to talk about some more Saints news. Saints, Alex Okafor comes back, Bushrod comes back, and other stories. You're listening to the Sports Coma with Big Q and the guys. Stay with us.